Murder in the first degree, premeditated homicide, is the most serious charge tried in our criminal courts. You have heard a long and complex case, ladies and gentlemen, and it is now your duty to sit down to try to separate the facts from the fancy. One man is dead. The life of another is at stake. If there's a reasonable doubt in your minds as to the guilt of the accused, then you must declare him not guilty. If, however, there is no reasonable doubt, then he must be found guilty. Whichever way you decide, the verdict must be unanimous. I urge you to deliberate honestly and thoughtfully. You are faced with a grave responsibility. Thank you all. The jury will retire.
He doesn't stand a chance.
Chewing gum?
Gum?
Thank you, but no.
You know something?
I know a lot of things. I'm in advertising.
You know, it's hot.
I never would have known that if you hadn't told me. Would you?
I suppose not. I'd kind of forgotten.
All I've done all day is sweat.
Bet you aren't sweating like that kid who was tried. You'd think that at least air-conditioned the place. I almost dropped dead in court.
My taxes are high enough.
It should go fast anyway.
Yes, it's hot.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, everybody's here. If there's anything you want, I'm right outside. Just knock.
Did he lock that door?
Yes, he did.
What do they think we are, crooks?
You know, they lock us up for a little while.
Yeah, and then they lock that kid up forever. And that's fine by me.
I never knew they did that.
Sure they lock the doors. What'd you think?
I don't know, it just never occurred to me.
Shall we all admit that it is hot and humid and our tempers are short?
It's been a pretty hard week.
I feel just fine.
I wonder what's going on at the office. You know how it is in advertising, and in 6 days I could lose my job and the whole company too. They aren't gonna like this.
Well, I think this is our duty.
I didn't object to doing my duty. I just mentioned that I might not have a job by the time I get back.
Well, ask her to hire you. Look at the suit. She's rich.
Is it an original?
Yes, it is.
No, I have an aunt who's a seamstress.
Oh, how does she do?
Not too well. You know, a friend of hers, that's a friend of my aunt, seamstress, she wanted to be on this jury in my place.
Why didn't you let her? I would have done anything to miss this.
And get caught or something. You know what kind of fine you could pay for something like that? Anyways, this friend of hers, she was on a jury about 10 years ago, a case just like this one.
What happened?
They let him loose. In reasonable doubt. And, you know, 8 years later, they found out he'd actually done it anyway. A guilty man, a murderer, was turned loose in the streets.
Could they get him?
They couldn't.
Why not?
Well, no one can be held in double jeopardy. Unless it's a hung jury, no one can try anyone twice for the same crime.
That isn't gonna happen here. 6 days. They should have been done in two. Talk. You ever hear someone talk about nothing?
Well, they're entitled.
Everybody gets a fair trial. That's the system. Can't say anything against it, I suppose.
Hey, how'd you like that business about the knife? You ever hear a phonier story?
Well, look, you gotta expect that sort of thing. You know what you're dealing with.
He bought a switch knife that night.
And then he lost it.
A hole in his pocket.
A hole in his father.
An awful way to kill your father. I mean, a knife in his chest.
Well, look at the kind of people they are. You know them.
What's the matter with you? You got a cold?
Lulu, these hot weather storms can kill you.
Tell me about it. I had one last year while I was on vacation, too.
All right, people, let's take seats.
Right. This better go fast. I've got tickets to go see Hamilton for tonight. I gotta be the only guy in the world who hasn't seen it yet. All right, Your Honor, start the show.
How about sitting down? Lady, by the window, sit down, please.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's tough to figure, isn't it? A kid kills his father, bang, just like that. Well, it's in their element, I suppose. They let the kids run loose in the streets. Maybe it serves them right.
There's no point in getting emotional about it. It's a question of evidence, not how we feel.
Well, we all agree that it was hot.
And that our tempers will get short.
That's if we get to disagree. But this is open and shut. Let's get it done.
All right. Now you all can do this any way you want to. I'm not going to make any rules. So we can discuss this first and then vote. That's one way. Or we can vote now and see where we stand.
Let's vote now. Who knows? Maybe we can all go home.
Yeah. Let's see who's where.
Right. Let's vote now.
Anybody doesn't want to vote? All right. All those voting guilty, raise your hands. 8, 9, 10, 11. It's 11 for guilty. Not guilty. 1. It's 11-1. Now we know where we stand.
Do you really think he's not guilty?
I don't know.
After 6 days, she doesn't know.
In 6 days, I could learn calculus. This is ABC.
I don't believe it's as simple as ABC.
I've never seen a guiltier man in my life.
What does a guilty man look like? He's not guilty unless we say he's guilty. Are you to vote on his face?
You sat in court and heard the same things I did. The man's a dangerous killer. You could see it.
Where do you look to see if someone's a killer?
Oh, well.
No, tell me. I'd like to know. Tell me what the facial characteristics of a killer are. Maybe you know something I don't know.
Look, what is there about this case that makes you think the boy's innocent?
He's 19 years old.
That's old enough. He knifed his own father 4 inches into the chest. Innocent little 19-year-old kid.
I agree with you that the boy is guilty, but I think we should try to avoid emotionally colored arguments.
All right. They proved it a dozen different ways. Do you want me to list them?
No.
Well, do you believe the kid's stupid story?
I don't know whether I believe it or not. Maybe I don't.
So what'd you vote not guilty for?
Well, there were 11 votes for guilty. It's not so easy for me to raise my hand and send a boy off to die without talking about it first.
Who says it's easy for me?
Or me.
No one.
The boy is still just as guilty, whether it's an easy vote or a hard one.
Is there something wrong because I voted fast?
Not necessarily.
Look, I think the kid's guilty. You couldn't change my mind if you talked for 100 years.
I don't want to change your mind.
Just what are you thinking of?
I just want to talk a while. Look, this kid's been pushed around all his life. You know, living in a slum, his mother dead since he was 9. He's a tough, angry kid. You know why slum kids get that way? It's because we knock them over the head all the time. I think maybe we owe him a few words, that's all.
All right, life's hard. It was hard for me. Everything I've got, I fought for. I worked my way through college, and that was a long time ago, so perhaps you do forget. But I worked. I fought. But I never killed.
I know what it's like. I never killed nobody.
I've been kicked around, too. Wait until you've worked in an ad agency and the big boys that buy the advertising walk in. We all know.
In my country, in Europe, kicking was an art form, but let's try to find something better than that.
Look, Missy, I don't mind telling you this. We don't know the kid a thing. He got a fair trial, didn't he? Do you know how much that trial cost? He's lucky he even got it. Come on, we're all grown-ups here. You're not supposed to tell us that we're supposed to believe the kid, knowing what he is. I've lived among them all my life. You can't trust a word they say.
I don't know that. What a terrible thing to believe. Since when is dishonesty a group characteristic? You don't have a monopoly on the truth.
All right. It's not Sunday. We don't need a sermon.
What this man says is very dangerous.
I don't see the need for arguing like this. I think we have to behave like adults.
Right.
If you insist.
Thank you.
Sure.
If we're going to discuss this case, why, let's discuss the facts.
I think that's a good idea. We have a job to do, so let's do it.
If you people don't mind, I'm going to close the window.
If you don't mind, I'd like to keep the window open.
But it was blowing on me.
Don't you want a little air? It's summer. It's hot.
I was very uncomfortable.
There are 12 of us in this room. It's the only window, if you don't mind.
I have some rights, too.
So do the rest of us.
Could you try trading chairs with someone at the other end of the table?
All right. I will open the window if someone would trade.
Here, take my chair.
Thank you.
Shall we get back to the case, please?
Yeah, let's.
I may have an idea here. I'm just thinking out loud now, but it seems to me that it's up to us to convince this lady that we're right and she's wrong. What if we each talk for a minute or two, you know, see where we stand?
That sounds all right with me. Mm-hmm. Anybody object? All right. Suppose we go once around the table? Okay. You're first.
Oh, I just think he's guilty. I thought it was obvious.
In what way was it obvious?
That no one proved otherwise?
Well, nobody has to prove otherwise. Innocent until proven guilty. The burden of proof is on the prosecution. The defendant doesn't have to open his mouth. That's in the Constitution, the Fifth Amendment. You've heard of it.
Everyone has.
Well, yes, I've heard of it. I mean was... Anyways, I think he's guilty.
No reasons, just guilty. There's a life at stake here.
Okay, let's get to the facts. Number one, let's take the old man who lived in the second floor right underneath the room where the murder took place. At 10 minutes after 12 on the night of the killing, he heard loud noises in the upstairs apartment. He said it sounded like a fight. Then he hears a body falling. Then he hears the kid say, "I'm gonna kill you," to his father. He hears the body falling, runs to the door of his apartment, looks out, and sees the kid running down the stairs and out of the apartment 15 seconds after that. Then he calls the police. They find the father with a knife in his chest.
And the coroner fixed the time of death at around midnight.
Right. Now what else do you want?
It doesn't seem to fit.
The boy's whole story is flimsy. He claims he was at the movies. That's a little ridiculous, isn't it? He didn't even remember what picture he saw.
That's right. You hear that? You're absolutely right.
He didn't even have a ticket stub.
Who keeps a ticket stub at the movies?
True enough.
I suppose, but the cashier didn't remember him either.
And the ticket taker didn't either.
Look, what about the woman across the street? If her testimony don't prove it, then nothing does.
That's right. She saw the killing, didn't she?
Excuse me. Let's go in order.
Now, wait just a minute. Here's a woman who can't sleep. She's lying in bed. It's hot, you know? Excuse me. Anyway, she wakes up to go look outside the window, and right across the street, she sees the kid sticking the knife into his father.
How can she really be so sure it was the boy when she saw it through the windows of a passing elevated train?
She's known the kid all his life. His window is right opposite hers, and she swore in court that she saw the killing.
Weren't you just telling us a minute or two ago that you can't trust them? That you can't believe them?
So?
Then I'd like to ask you something. How come you believe her? She's one of them, too, isn't she?
You're a pretty smart lady, aren't you?
Now take it easy.
Come on, sit down. What are you letting her get you all upset for? Come on, relax.
They did take us out to the woman's room, and we all looked through the windows of a passing L train, didn't we?
Yes, we looked.
And weren't you able to see what happened on the other side?
I didn't see as well as they told me I would, but I did see what happened, yes.
Do you see now?
Now let's calm down. It's your turn.
I'll pass it.
That's your privilege. How about you?
I don't know. What convinced me was the testimony of those people across the hall. Didn't they say something about an argument between the father and the boy at about 7 o'clock that night? I mean, I could be wrong.
I think it was 8 o'clock, not 7.
That's right, 8 o'clock.
They heard the father hit the boy twice and then saw the boy walk angrily out of the house.
Right.
Well, what does that prove?
It doesn't exactly prove anything. It's just a part of the picture. I didn't say it proved anything.
Anything else?
No.
I don't know. Most of it's been said already. We can talk all day about this thing, but it wouldn't change a thing.
I don't think so.
Neither do I. Go on.
I mean, look at the kid's record. He stole a car. He's been arrested for mugging. I think they even said he stabbed somebody in the arm.
They did.
At 15, he was picked up for knife fighting, and he was sent to reform school.
And they sent him to reform school for stabbing someone.
This is a very fine boy.
Ever since he was 5 years old, his father beat him up regularly. He used his fists.
So would I, on a kid like that.
You're right, it's the kids. The way they are, you know, they don't listen. I got a kid. Yeah, when he was 8 years old, he ran away from a fight. I saw him. I was so ashamed. And I told him right out, I said, I'm gonna make a man out of you. I'm gonna bust you up into little pieces trying. When he was 15, he hit me in the face. Big kid, you know. I haven't seen him in 3 years. Rotten kid, man. I hate tough kids. You work your heart out and... let's get on with it.
I think we're missing the point here. This boy, let's admit that he's the product of a filthy neighborhood. We can't help that. We're not here to go into reasons why slums are breeding grounds for criminals. They are. I know it, and so do you. Children from slum backgrounds are potential menaces to society.
You said it there. I don't want any part of them, believe me.
I've lived in a slum all my
life. Just wait a minute.
I used to play in backyards filled with garbage. Maybe it still smells on me.
Now let's be reasonable. There's nothing personal
there
about it.
There is something personal!
Calm down, lady. He didn't mean you.
Who did he mean?
I can understand this sensitivity.
Now let's stop all this bickering.
We're wasting time.
It's your turn.
All right. I had a peculiar feeling about this case. Somehow, I felt like the defense counsel never really conducted a thorough cross-examination.
Well, it doesn't change my opinion about the guilt of the boy. Still, I do agree the defense counsel was bad.
So?
This is the point.
What about facts?
So many questions were never answered.
And what about the questions that were answered? For instance, let's talk about that cute little switch knife. You know, the one that fine, upright kid admitted buying.
All right, let's talk about it. Let's... get in here and take another look at it. I'd like to see it again, Madam Foreman.
I think we all know what it looks like. I don't see why we have to look at it again. What do you think?
The lady has a right to see exhibits and evidence.
Okay by me.
The knife is a pretty strong piece of evidence, don't you agree?
I do.
Okay, and so let's get the sequence of events right as they relate to the switch knife.
Boy admits going out of his house at 8 o'clock after being slapped by his father.
Or punched.
The boy went to the neighborhood store and bought a switch knife. The storekeeper was arrested the following day when he admitted selling it to the boy.
I want you to listen to this lady. She knows what she's talking about.
It's a pretty strange knife. The storekeeper identified it as the only one of its kind that he had in stock. And why did the boy get it?
As a present for a friend of his, he says.
Am I right so far?
Right?
You bet she's right! Now keep listening!
Next, the boy claims that on his way home, the knife must have fallen out of a hole in his coat pocket. Says he never saw it again. Now there's a story, ladies and gentlemen. You all know what actually happened. The boy took the knife home and a few hours later stabbed his father with it and even remembered to wipe away the fingerprints. Thank you. Everyone connected with the case identified this knife. Now, are you trying to tell me that someone else picked it up off the street, went up to the boy's house, and stabbed the father with it just to be amusing?
No, I'm saying it's possible that the boy lost the knife and somebody else stabbed his father with a similar knife. It's possible.
Take a look at that knife. It's a very strange knife. I've never seen anything like it before in my life, and neither had the storekeeper who sold it. Aren't you trying to make us accept a pretty incredible coincidence?
I'm not trying to make anyone accept it. I'm just saying it's possible.
And I'm saying it's not possible! What are you trying to do here?
Look at it. It's the same knife.
Quiet. Let's be quiet.
Where did you get that?
I got it in a little junk shop around the corner from the boys' house. It cost $2.
Now listen to me.
I'm listening.
You pulled a real smart trick here, but it proves absolutely zero. Maybe there are 10 knives like that. So what?
Maybe there are.
The boy lied and you know it.
And maybe he didn't lie. Maybe he did lose the knife and maybe he did go to the movies. Maybe the reason the cashier didn't see him at the movies was because he snuck in. And maybe he was too ashamed to say so. Is there anyone here who didn't sneak into the movies once or twice when they were young?
I didn't.
Really? Not even once?
We didn't have movies.
Oh.
Maybe he did sneak into the movies, and maybe he didn't. And he may have lied. Do you think he lied?
Of course he lied. The boy's a liar.
Do you?
You don't have to ask me that. You know my answer. He lied.
Do you think he lied? I don't know.
Now wait a second. What are you, the guy's lawyer? Just what are you trying to accomplish? If you want to be stubborn and hang this jury, why, he'll be tried again and found guilty, as sure as he's born.
You're probably right.
So what are you going to do about it? We can be here all night.
It's only one night. A man may die.
Oh, come on.
Well, yes, that's true. I think we should get back to the case.
All right, let's get on with it. Well, what do you say? You're the one holding up the show.
Obviously, you think the boy's not guilty.
I have a doubt in my mind.
But you really haven't presented anything to us that makes it possible for us to understand that doubt. There was the old man downstairs. He heard it.
The woman across the L tracks. She saw it.
Look, we know he bought a switch knife that night, and we don't know where he really was. At the movies?
Earlier that night, the boy and the father did have a fight.
He's been a violent boy all the way, and while that doesn't
still
prove
though, it kind of...
I've got a proposition to make. I want to call for a vote. I want the 11 of you to vote by secret ballot. I'll abstain. There's still 11 votes for guilty. I won't stand alone. We'll take in a guilty verdict right now.
Okay, let's do it.
That sounds fair. Is everyone agreed?
I certainly am.
Let's roll it.
Guilty. 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 Guilty.
That's six.
Please. Guilty. 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 Not guilty. Guilty.
How do you like that? Who was it?
I think we have a right to know.
All right, who was it? What idiot changed their vote?
Is that the way to talk about a man's life?
Whose life are you talking about? The life of the dead man or the life of the murderer?
I want to know. Who?
So do I.
Excuse me, this was a secret ballot.
No one looked while we did it, but now I want to know.
A secret ballot. We agreed on this point, no? If the person wants to remain a secret...
What do you... There are no secrets in here! I know who it was. What's the matter with you? You come in here and vote guilty, and now this slick preacher starts tearing your heart out with stories about a poor little slum kid who just couldn't help becoming a murderer. So you change your vote, if that's not the most
now
sickening...
Now hold it!
I agree with you that the boy's guilty, but can we be fair, please?
Hold it? Be fair? That's just what I'm saying! We're trying to put a guilty man in the chair where he belongs! All of a sudden, we're paying attention to fairy tales!
Now, just a minute. Now,
you listen to me!
Now, let's calm down!
I thought we had the right to hold unpopular opinions in this country.
I have always thought that people in this country were entitled to have unpopular opinions. That is why I came here. I wanted to have the right to disagree.
Well, do you disagree with us?
Usually I would. In this one case, I agree with you. But the point I wish to make is that in my own country, I am
now
ashamed.
What? Do we have to listen to the entire history of your country?
It's always wise to bear in mind what has happened in other countries when people aren't allowed to disagree, but we are. So let's stick to the subject.
Yeah, let's stick to the subject. I want to ask you, what made you change your vote?
I want to know too. You haven't told us yet.
Just what makes you think I changed my vote?
Because I do. Now go on.
There is nothing for her to tell you. She didn't change her vote. I did. I was going to tell you, but you were so sure of yourselves.
Sorry. Okay, then?
Maybe you'd like to know why.
Let me tell you
the
why
that- The lady's trying to speak.
Thank you. This woman chose not to stand alone against us. That's her right. It takes a great deal of courage to stand alone, even if you believe in something very strongly. She left the verdict up to us. She gambled for support, and I gave it to her. I want to hear more. The vote is 10-2.
That's great. The speech is over. Let's move on.
If there was anything in favor of the boy, I'd vote not guilty.
I don't see what it is.
Neither do I. They're clutching at straws.
As guilty as they get, that's the boy, I suppose.
Yeah, well, it's that one juror who's holding out, but she'll come around eventually. She's got to, and fundamentally, she is a very reasonable person.
I guess.
They just haven't come up with one real fact yet to back up a not guilty verdict.
Well, I mean, it is hard, you know?
Yes, it is. I guess what does guilty beyond a reasonable doubt really mean?
Yeah, what is a reasonable doubt?
Exactly. When a life is at stake, what is a reasonable doubt? You've got to have law and order. You've got to draw the line somewhere. If not, everyone would start knifing people.
Not much doubt here.
Well, two women think so. I wonder why. I really wonder why.
Well, I mean, you do hear stories sometimes about innocent men who are sent to jail, or death, even. And then years later, things just turn up.
Yes, but on the other hand, some killers get turned loose and then they go out and do it again. They squeeze out on some technicality and kill. Again.
Look, Missy, now that we've cooled off a bit, why, I got a little excited a minute ago. I didn't mean to get nasty. Nothing personal.
Think nothing of it.
Look, supposing you answer me this. If the boy didn't kill him, who did?
As far as I know, we're only supposed to decide whether or not the boy on trial's guilty. We're not concerned with anyone else's motives here.
Right, but who else had a motive?
The boy's father was along in years, maybe an old grudge.
Remember, it's guilty beyond a reasonable doubt. It's an important thing to remember.
Everyone's a lawyer. Supposing you tell us what some of those reasonable doubts are?
This isn't easy. So far, it's only a feeling I have.
A feeling perhaps you don't understand.
Nope, I don't.
A feeling? What are we gonna do, spend the night talking about your feelings? What about the facts?
You said a mouthful. Look, the old man heard the kid yell, "I'm gonna kill you." A second later, he hears the father's body falling. And then he sees the kid running out of the house 15 seconds after that.
Now, if that isn't beyond a reasonable doubt, then what is?
Let's not forget the woman across the street. She looked into the open window and saw the boy stab his father. She saw it!
If that's not enough for you.
It's not enough for me.
Well, then what is enough for you? I'd like to know.
Well, I don't know. It just doesn't seem right to me.
Supposing you think about it.
The woman saw the killing through the windows of an elevated train. The train had five cars, and she saw it through the windows of the last two cars. She remembers the most insignificant details.
That's right. What do you think of that?
I don't know.
Well, keep thinking, I guess. Give me your pencil. Let's play some tic-tac-toe. Might as well pass the time.
This isn't a game.
Wait a minute.
This is the boy's life.
Who do you think you are?
All right, take it easy.
Did you hear her? I got a good mind to walk around this table and belt her one.
Now, please, I don't want any fights
here. The nerve! The absolute nerve!
How about sitting down?
This isn't a game. Who does she think she is?
Weren't we talking about elevated trains?
Yes, we were.
So?
All right, how long does it take an elevated train going at top speed to pass a given point?
What has that got to do with anything?
How long would it take? Guess.
I wouldn't have the slightest idea.
Neither would I.
Nobody mentioned it.
What do you think?
About 10 or 12 seconds, maybe.
I see that was a fair guess. Anyone else?
I would think about 10 seconds, perhaps.
About 10 seconds. Yes.
All right, we're agreed. 10 seconds. What are you getting at?
This. An L train passes a given point in 10 seconds. That given point, in this case, is the window of the room in which the killing took place. You can almost reach out of that window and touch the L, right?
That's right, I've tried it.
So?
Well, I'd like to ask you all something. Has anyone here ever lived next to the L tracks?
I have.
They make a lot of noise, don't they? I've lived right by the L tracks. When the windows open and the train goes by, the noise is almost unbearable. You can't hear yourself think.
So you can hear yourself think. What's the point you're getting at?
The old man testified that he heard the voice say, "I'm going to kill you," when... The old man testified that he heard the boy say, "I'm going to kill you."
He didn't say it. He screamed it.
The old man heard the boy scream, "I'm going to kill you." And then 1 second later heard the body fall. 1 second. That's the testimony, right?
Right.
And the old woman looked through the windows of the last two cars of the L and saw the body fall, right?
Right.
Last two cars of the L and then...
What are you getting at?
An L train passes a given point in 10 seconds, or 2 seconds per car. That L had been going by the old man's window for at least 6 seconds and maybe more before the body fell, according to the woman. The old man must have heard the boy scream, "I'm going to kill you," while the front of the L was roaring past his nose. It's not possible he could have heard it.
What do you mean? Sure, he could have heard it.
With an L train going by.
He said the boy screamed it out.
An L train makes a lot of noise.
It's enough for me.
It's enough for me, too.
I don't think he could have heard it.
I mean, maybe the old man didn't hear it. I mean, with the L noise...
What are you people talking about? Are you calling the old man a liar?
Something doesn't fit.
Well, it stands to reason...
You're crazy! Why would he lie? What's he got to gain?
Attention, maybe.
You keep coming up with these bright sayings. Why don't you send one down to the newspaper? They paid $2.
What does that have to do with a boy's life? Why might the old man have lied? You have a right to be heard.
It's just that I looked at him for a very long time. The seam of his jacket was split under the arm. Did you notice that? He was a very old man with a torn jacket, and he carried two canes. I think I know him better than anyone here. This is a quiet, frightened, insignificant man who has been nothing all his life, who has never had recognition. His name in the newspapers, nobody knows him after 75 years. This is a very sad thing. A man like this needs to be recognized, to be questioned and listened to and quoted just once. This is very important.
You're trying to tell us he lied about a thing like this so he could be important.
No, he wouldn't really lie. But perhaps he'd make himself believe that he heard those words and saw the boy's face.
Wow. That is the most fantastic story I've ever heard. Where do you make up a thing like that?
I'm not making it up.
You must be making it up. People don't lie about things like that.
He made himself believe he told the truth.
What do you know about it?
I speak from experience.
What?
I am the same person.
Okay. Is there anything else?
Cough drop?
No,
thank you. Does anyone else want a cough drop?
Can we get back to the case, please? I'll take one. Thank you. Now, there's something else I'd like to point out here. I think we proved that the old man couldn't have heard the boy say, "I'm going to kill you."
Well, I disagree.
Let's hear her through anyway.
But supposing the old man did hear the boy say, "I'm going to kill you," this phrase, how many times has each of you used it? Probably hundreds. If you do that once more, Junior, I'm gonna murder you. Or go on, Rocky, kill him. We use it every day. It doesn't mean we're really going to kill someone.
Don't the circumstances alter that somewhat?
The old man was murdered.
One thing more. The phrase was, "I'm going to kill you." And the kid screamed it out at the top of his lungs.
Anyone says a phrase like that, they mean it.
And how they mean it?
Well, let me ask you this. Do you really think the boy would scream out a thing like that so the whole neighborhood would hear him? I don't think so. He's much too bright for that.
Bright? He's a common ignorant slob. He don't even speak good English.
He doesn't even speak good English.
The boy is clever enough.
I'd like to change my vote. Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
The vote is 9-3 in favor of guilty.
What made you change your vote?
There's a doubt.
Where? What's the doubt?
There's the knife.
Oh, fine.
This lady is believing you in fairy tales.
Go on. Give us the reasons.
Maybe the old man didn't lie. But just then, maybe he did. Maybe the old man doesn't like the boy very much.
Well, if that isn't the end.
There is a reasonable doubt.
And what are you basing it on? Stories that this lady made up. Why, she ought to write for Amazing Detective Monthly. She'd make a fortune. Listen, the kid had lawyers, didn't he? Why didn't his lawyers bring up all these points?
Lawyers can't think of everything.
Oh, brother. You sit in here and pull stories out of thin air. And now, we're supposed to believe that the old man didn't get up out of bed, didn't run to the door, didn't see the kid, beat it downstairs 15 seconds after the killing?
That is the testimony, I believe.
And the old man swore to this. Yes, he swore to this just so he could get attention.
Did the old man say he ran to the door?
Ran. Walked. What's the difference? He got there.
Well, I don't know what he said. But I don't see how he could run.
He said he went. I remember it now. He went from his bedroom to the front door. That's enough, isn't it?
Where was his bedroom again?
Down the hall somewhere.
Down the hall somewhere? Are we to send a boy off to die because it's down the hall somewhere?
I thought you remembered everything.
No, I don't.
I don't remember either.
Madam Foreman, I'd like to see the diagram of the apartment.
Oh, are we to run over this whole trial just so you can get everything straight?
The room is down the hall somewhere. Do you know where it is? Please, a boy's life is at stake. Do you know?
Well, it's...
Madam Foreman, I heard you.
All right, what's this one for? How come you're the only one in the room who wants to see exhibits all the time?
I want to see this one too. So do I.
And I want to stop wasting time.
Are we going to start waiting around all that nonsense about where the body was found?
We're not. We're going to find out how a man who's had two strokes in the past 3 years and who walks with a pair of canes could get to his front door in 15 seconds.
He said 20 seconds.
He said 15.
How could he know how long 15 seconds is? You can't judge that kind of thing.
He said 15. He was very positive about it.
He's an old man. Half the time he was confused. You saw that. How could he be positive about anything? Well, you know...
No, I don't know. Maybe you know.
Is this what you wanted?
That's right. Thank you.
Sure. That's my job.
You wanted this?
Yes, please.
Do me a favor. Wake me up when this is all over.
I looked at that diagram for 2 hours. Enough is enough.
Some of us are actually interested. Go ahead.
All right. This is the diagram of the apartment in which the killing took place. The old man's apartment is directly beneath it and exactly the same. Here's the L tracks, bedroom, living room, bathroom, kitchen, and this is the hall. Here's the front door to the apartment, and here are the stairs. Now, the old man was in bed in this room. He says he got up, went out into the hall, down the hall to the front door, and opened it just in time to see the boy racing down the stairs.
That's the story.
That's how it happened.
15 seconds after he heard the body fall.
Correct.
His bed was at the window. It's 12 feet from his bed to the bedroom door. The length of the hall is 43 feet 6 inches. He had to get out of bed, get his canes, walk 12 feet, open the bedroom door, walk 43 feet, and then open the front door. All in 15 seconds. Do you think this is possible?
You know it's possible.
I don't see why not.
He would have been in a hurry. He did hear the kid yell, "I'm gonna kill you."
He can only walk very slowly. They had to help him into the witness chair.
You make it sound like it's a long walk. It's not.
For an old man with canes, it's a long walk.
What are you doing?
I want to try this thing. Let's see how long it took him. I'm going to pace off 12 feet, the length of the bedroom.
See, you're crazy. You can't recreate that kind of thing.
Perhaps if we could see it, this is an important point.
This is a ridiculous waste of time.
Let her do it.
Hand me a chair, please. All right, this is going to be the door to the hallway. How far would you say it's from here to that flagpole?
About 20 feet, maybe?
Just about.
Right, 20 feet's close enough. From here and back is 40 feet. It's shorter than the length of the hall the old man had to move through. Wouldn't you say that?
A few feet, maybe.
Look, this is absolutely ridiculous. What makes you think you can do this?
We can't stop her.
Do you mind if I try it? According to you, it will only take 15 seconds. We can spare that. Does anyone have a watch with a second hand?
I have.
All right, when you want me to start, stamp your foot. That will be the body falling.
We'll time you from there.
Let's say he keeps his canes right at his bedside.
Right.
All right, I'm ready.
I'm waiting for the little hand to get to 60.
Speed it up. You walk twice as fast as that.
This is, I think, even more quickly than the old man walked in the courtroom.
No, it isn't.
If you want me to go faster, I will.
Speed it up a little.
Stop.
Right.
What's the time?
15, 20, 30, 35. 39 seconds exactly.
That can't be.
39 seconds.
That's interesting.
Well, now, you know.
What do you think of that?
39 seconds. 39.
And the old man swore on his oath that it was only 15.
He may have been a little bit off on the speed that the old man moved at, but 24 seconds off, well, now, you know.
Far be it from me to call anyone a liar, but even allowing for quite a difference in time between the old man and you, why, there's still quite a
discrepancy.
It's my guess that the old man was trying to get to the door, heard someone racing down the stairs, and assumed that it was the boy.
I think that's possible.
Assumed? Now listen to me, you people. I've seen all kinds of dishonesty in my day, but this little display takes the cake.
What dishonesty?
Tell her. You come in here with your heart bleeding all over the floor, talking about slum kids and injustice, and you make up all these wild stories, and you got some soft-hearted old ladies listening to you. Well, I'm not. I'm getting real sick of you. What is the matter with you people? This kid is guilty. He's got a burn. We're letting him slip through our fingers.
Our fingers? Are you his executioner?
I'm one of them.
Perhaps you'd like to pull the switch.
For this kid, you bet I'd like to pull the switch.
I'm sorry for you.
Don't start with me.
What it must feel like to want to pull the switch.
Shut up.
You're a sadist.
Shut up.
You want to see this boy die because it would satisfy you personally, not because of the facts. You disgust
me. Shut up. Let me go. I'll kill her. I'll kill her.
You don't really mean you'll kill me, do you?
Something wrong, ladies and gentlemen? I heard some noise.
No, nothing's wrong. You can take that back. We're done with it.
Well, what are you looking at?
I don't see why we have to behave like children.
Nor do I. We have a responsibility. This is a remarkable thing about democracy. That we are, what is the word? Notified. That we are notified by mail to come down to this place and decide on the guilt or innocence of a person, of a man or woman we have not known before. We have nothing to gain or lose by our verdict. This is one of the reasons why we are strong. We should not make it into a personal thing.
Thank you very much.
Why do you thank me?
We forget. It's good to be reminded.
I'm glad we're going to be civilized about this.
Well, we're still nowhere.
No, we're somewhere. Or getting there, maybe.
Maybe.
Who's got an idea?
I think maybe we should try another vote. Madam Foreman?
All right.
That sounds good to me. Anybody doesn't want to vote?
Let's vote.
Yes, vote.
So, all right, let's do it.
I want an open ballot. Let's call out our votes. I want to know who stands where.
That sounds fair. Anybody object? Okay. I'll call out your jury numbers. I vote guilty. Number two.
Not guilty.
Number three.
Guilty.
Four.
Guilty.
Five.
Not guilty.
Six.
Not guilty.
Seven.
Guilty.
Eight.
Not guilty.
Nine.
Not guilty.
10.
Guilty.
11.
Not guilty.
12.
Guilty.
That's 6-6.
I'll tell you something. The real crime is being committed right here in this room.
The vote is 6-6.
I'm ready to walk into court right now and declare hung jury. There's no point in going on with this anymore.
I'd like to know why you changed your mind. And why you changed your mind and why you did. There are 6 people in here who think that we might be turning a murderer loose, so emotion won't do. Why?
Well, it would seem that the old man did not see the boy run downstairs. I do not think it likely that the old man heard someone scream, "I'm going to kill you." Old men dream. And if the boy did scream that he was going to kill, then we have the authority of this person to prove that it might not actually mean he's going to kill.
Why don't we take it into the judge and let 12 other guys decide?
Now, can we get on with this, please?
We're not going to be a hung jury.
But we are, right now. Perfect balance. Let's take it into the judge.
If there is a reasonable doubt, I don't see it.
The doubt is there in my mind.
Maybe we should vote.
What do you mean, vote?
Not again.
What are we voting on?
Vote on what?
Are we or aren't we a hung jury?
You mean that we vote yes, we are a hung jury, or no, we are not a hung jury?
That's just what I was thinking of.
I'm not sure we could even agree on whether or not we're a hung jury.
It's gotta be unanimous.
We can't even agree about whether or not the window should be open.
Well, then we'll make it a majority vote. A majority wins.
So if 7 or more of us vote yes, that we are a hung jury, we will take it into the judge and tell him that we are a hung jury?
Right. And if 7 or more of us vote no, then we aren't a hung jury, and we keep on discussing it.
That doesn't seem quite right to me.
The only solution.
Anything to end this.
All right. Anybody doesn't want to vote? All right. I'll call a few jury numbers. I vote yes, we are a hung jury. 2.
No.
3.
Yes.
4.
Yes.
5.
No.
6.
No.
7.
Yes.
8.
No.
9.
No.
10.
Yes.
11.
No.
12.
Yes.
Oh, no!
6-6.
We can't even get a majority to decide whether or not we're a hung jury.
I went along with the majority vote on this question. But I didn't really agree with voting that way, not really, and I still don't, so I'm changing my vote. I say no, we are not a hung jury. I believe that the boy's guilty beyond a reasonable doubt, but there are some things that I want to know from those who change their minds.
Then we aren't a hung jury, so we go on.
Good, we go on.
Why did you change your mind?
Oh, well, I mean, she seems so sure of herself, and she has made a lot of good points, while he just gets mad and insults everyone.
Does the anger and insult change the guilt of the boy? He did do it. Are you going to turn a murderer loose just because one of the jurors becomes angry when he thinks a murderer is being turned loose?
That's true.
There is a reasonable doubt.
I don't think so. The track is straight in front of the window. Let's take that point. The L train would have made a low, rumbling noise. L trains screech when they go around curves, so the old man could have heard the boy scream because that is high-pitched, And it is a tenement, and they have thin walls.
Good, good. That's it.
And what if the old man was wrong about the time it took him to get to the door, but right about whom he saw? Also, please remember there weren't any fingerprints on the knife, and it is summer, so gloves seem unlikely.
I want you to listen to this lady. She's got the goods.
So, let's time it.
Just what are we timing?
Yeah, let's be exact, please.
I am saying that the old man might have been wrong about how long it took him to get to the door, but right about whom he saw running downstairs. Now, it may have taken the murderer about 35 seconds in order to get out a handkerchief and get down the stairs to the place where the old man saw him, the boy, that is.
This is right.
Now, we reconstructed the old man getting out of bed and going to the door, and we timed that. Why don't we reconstruct the actual crime?
As well as we can reconstruct it.
I think a murderer could use up 30 or 40 seconds pretty easily at that point.
Let's reconstruct the killing.
Yes, let's.
Here. You do the stabbing.
No, I'll do it.
Okay. Why don't you be the one that gets stabbed? You're younger than I am. And don't forget, he takes 1 second to fall.
And he was found on his side, his right side, so fall and roll onto your right side. Also, he would have wiped the fingerprints away, and that might have taken a few seconds. And also, if someone hates another person enough to kill them, don't you think it's reasonable to assume that the murderer would look at his victim for a second or two?
It's human nature.
Seems reasonable to me.
Wait a minute. He ends up on his right side, the father does, but stabbing someone isn't like shooting them, even if it's right in the heart. You would have worked around for a bit, lying on the ground maybe, writhing.
That's quite possible. He would have had enough oxygen in his system to carry him for about 2 or 3 seconds, I should think.
Wouldn't the father have cried out?
Yeah, maybe the kid held his mouth.
That also seems possible.
Also, there's one more point we might bring out. Anyone who is clear enough to wipe the fingerprints away on the knife after murdering someone, well, that person is also clear enough mentally to look around the apartment, or the room in this case, for any other clues. Should only be a second or two, I should think, but still, he would look around.
This gets better and better.
We're trying to make it clear. One doesn't talk about quality when murder is involved.
Also, on the fingerprints, the boy wiped his fingerprints from the knife. What about the doorknobs? If I saw a man coming into my home, a man that hated me, and he was wiping the doorknob with a handkerchief, I'd start screaming. So the doorknob must have been wiped after the killing, and this too would take some time.
You time the last one, why don't you time this one too?
All right.
Stomp your foot when you want me to start.
I am waiting for the little hand to get to 60.
I'm going to kill you. You would have wiped both doorknobs. Stop.
29 and a half seconds, I'd say.
And whoever did murder the old man, and I think it was the boy, still had to get down the stairs, at least one flight of stairs, to where the old man saw him.
This is right.
So the old man might have been wrong in the time it took him to get to the door, but in view of this, I think it's reasonable to assume that he did see the boy run downstairs.
So now both time sequences check, the one you did and the one we did. What with running down the stairs and everything, it pretty much checks out.
Sure, he's an old man who wants attention. She's probably right, but the old man feels the way everyone does. The boy's life is at stake.
So this story of the old man may well be true.
Except for the fact that he absolutely swore under oath that it was only 15 seconds.
We all seem to agree that it was at least 25 to 35 seconds later.
You're now admitting that the old man told the truth in one case and lied in another. I do admit this does tend to prove the story of the old man, but in part, he's now a proven liar. And this is by your own admission.
While it may be true that the old man lied in part, I think it will still be enough to change my vote once more. Guilty.
What about you? What do you think?
I'm not just sure what I think. I want to talk more. At first I thought guilty, and then I changed. Now I'm sort of swinging back to guilty.
What about you?
No, I am now in real doubt. Real doubt.
I say guilty. I was right the first time.
Now we're starting to make some sense in here.
The vote seems to be 9 votes guilty and 3 not guilty.
And one more thing about the old man downstairs. How many of you live in apartment buildings?
I don't know what you're thinking, but I know what I am thinking.
What's that?
I do not live in a tenement, but it is close. And there is just enough light in the hallway so you can see the steps. No more. This murder took place in a tenement. Remember how we stumbled on the steps?
The police officers were using these big bulbs, and one even had a flashlight.
An old man who misjudged the time by 20 seconds, on this we all agree. The old man looked down the dark hallway and recognized a running figure.
He was 100% wrong about the time. It took twice as long as he thought.
Then could the old man not be 100% wrong about who he saw?
That's the most idiotic thing I've ever heard. You're pulling that out of thin air.
We're a hung jury. I think we should be honest about it.
Do you truly believe there is no room for reasonable doubt?
Yes, I do.
I beg your pardon, but maybe you don't understand the term reasonable doubt?
What do you mean I don't understand it? Who do you think you are to talk to me like that? How do you like this lady? She comes here running for her life, and before she can even take a big breath, why, she's running the show! The arrogance of her.
No one is asking where anyone came from.
I was born right here.
Or where your mother came from.
Maybe it wouldn't hurt us to take a few tips from people who come running here. Maybe they know something we don't know. We're not so perfect.
Please, I'm used to this. It is all right, thank you.
No, it's not all right.
Okay. I apologize. Is that what you wanted?
That's what I wanted.
All right, can we stop this arguing? Does anyone have something constructive to say?
I think I do. There's something that's been bothering me this whole time. The whole business about the stab wound, the downward angle of it, you know?
Oh, don't tell me we're gonna start with that. They went over it and over it in court.
I know they did, but I don't go along with it. The boy is 5'8" tall. His father was 6'2" tall. That's a difference of 6 inches. It's a very awkward thing to stab down into the chest of a man who's more than 1/2 foot taller than you.
Look, you're not gonna be satisfied till you see it again. I'm gonna give you a little demonstration. Somebody get up. Okay. Now I want you to watch this. I don't want to have to do it again. Is that 6 inches?
It's more than 6.
Okay, let it be more.
Look out!
That's not funny!
What is the matter with you?
Calm down. Nobody's hurt, are they?
No, no one's hurt.
All right, there's your angle. Down and in. That's how I'd stab a taller man, and that's how it was done. Take a look at it. Tell me I'm wrong.
Down and in. I guess there's no argument.
Have you ever stabbed someone?
Of course not.
Have you?
All right, let's not be silly.
Have you?
No, I didn't.
Well, where do you get all your information about how it's done?
What do you mean? It's just common sense.
The boy was an experienced knife fighter. He was even sent to reform school for knifing someone. Isn't that so?
That's right.
Well, doesn't this seem like a very awkward way to handle a knife? Wait a minute. Just what's the matter with me? Give me that knife.
Have you ever seen a knife fight?
Yes, I have.
In the movies?
In my backyard, on my stoop. In vacant lots across the street, too many of them. Such knives came in the neighborhood where I lived. Funny, I didn't remember it. I guess you try to forget those things. Anyone who's ever used a switch knife would have never stabbed downwards. You don't handle a switch knife that way. You use it underhanded.
Then he couldn't have made the type of wound that killed his father.
I suppose it's conceivable that he could have made the wound, but it's not likely. Not if the boy had any experience with switch knives, and, well, we know the boy had lots of experience.
I don't believe it.
Neither do I. You're feeding us a bunch of mumbo-jumbo.
What do you think?
Well, I don't know.
What about you?
Listen, I'll tell you all something. I'm getting a little sick of this whole thing already. We're getting nowhere fast. Let's pack it up and go home.
Before we pack it up, I'd like to try and wrap this thing together.
This should be good.
You want me to time this one, too?
No, let's hear her out.
No, I'm in advertising. Did you guys know that? Anyway, I'm used to the big shots pulling things together. Let's chip up a few shots and see where they land, right?
I want you all to look at this logically and consistently.
We have. Guilty.
I want to know. Is the boy smart or is he dumb?
What do you mean?
The boy is an experienced knife fighter. He was even sent to reform school for knifing someone. The night of the murder, he bought a knife, a switch knife. It would then take a very stupid boy to go and murder a man, his father, with an instrument that everyone would associate with the son.
I quite agree. He's dumb.
However, if he were dumb, then why did he make the type of wound that only an inexperienced man would make with a knife? To murder someone must take great emotion, great hatred. And at that moment, the boy would handle the knife as best he could. And an experienced knife fighter would handle it as he had been trained. Underhand. A man who had not been trained would go overhand. But the boy's being very smart. Everyone knows that he's an experienced knife fighter, so at that moment, he makes the type of wound that only an amateur would make. That boy's a smart one. Smart enough to wipe fingerprints away, perhaps even smart enough to wait until an L train was going by in order to cover the noise. Now, is the boy smart or is he dumb?
Wait a minute.
Well, the woman across the L track saw the murder through the L train, so someone in that L train could have seen the murder as well.
A possibility, but no one did that we know of.
It would take an awfully dumb man to take that chance.
Exactly, a dumb man, a very stupid man, a man driven by emotion. He probably heard nothing. Probably didn't even hear the train coming. And whoever did murder the father did it as well as he could.
So?
The boy's dumb enough to do everything to associate himself with the switch knife. A switch knife murder. And then a moment after the murder, he becomes smart. The boy's smart enough to make the kind of wound that would lead us to suspect someone else. And yet at the same instant, he's dumb enough to do the killing as an L train's going by. And then a moment later, he's smart enough to wipe fingerprints away. To make the boy guilty, you have to say that he's dumb from 8 o'clock until midnight. And then around midnight, he's smart for a second, and then dumb for a few seconds, and then smart, and then stupid. So stupid, he doesn't think of a good alibi. Now, is the boy smart or is he dumb? To make him guilty, you have to toss his intelligence like a pancake. There's doubt.
I guess I hadn't thought of that.
And the old man downstairs, on the stand, he swore that it was 15 seconds. He insisted on 15 seconds, but we all agree it was closer to 40 seconds.
Does the old man lie half the time, and then does he tell the truth the other half?
To say the boy's guilty, you have to say that he's stupid and smart and stupid and smart and so on, and the old man must tell the truth for half of the time and be a liar for the other half. You can reasonably doubt.
I think I'm sold. Unreasonable doubt.
I think I am too.
I wanted more talk and now I've had it.
I want to call for another vote. Okay. Another vote's been called for. I think the easiest way is by a show of hands. All those voting not guilty, raise your hands. Nine. All those voting guilty? Three. The vote is 9-3 in favor of acquittal.
I don't understand you people. How can you think this boy's innocent? Look, you know how those people lie.
I don't have to tell you. They don't know what the truth is. And let me tell you, they don't need any big real reason to go and kill someone either. Look, nobody's blaming them. It's just how they are, you know what I mean? Violent! Human life don't mean as much to them as it does to us. Look, these people are drinking and fighting all the time. If somebody gets killed, so somebody gets killed. They don't care. Oh, sure, I've met a few of them who are pretty decent. Look, I'm the first to say that. I've met a few. They're the exception. Most of them, it's like they have no feelings. They can do anything. Where are you going? I'm trying to speak my piece and you... Listen to me! This boy is guilty! Wow. This boy. Everyone in my life who I've seen like this boy. Let me tell you. Every single last one of them. There's not a single one we can trust.
I've had enough! If you open your mouth again, I'm going to split your skull. Do you understand me?
I'm only trying to tell you.
Do you understand? All right, everyone sit down. Everyone. I still believe the boy is guilty, and I'll tell you why. To me, the most damning piece of evidence was given by the woman across the street who actually saw the murder committed.
That's right. As far as I'm concerned, that's the most important testimony.
Frankly, in view of this, I don't understand how you could vote for acquittal.
All right, let's go over her testimony. What exactly did she say?
I believe I can recount it accurately. She said she went to bed at about 11 o'clock. Her bed was right next to the open window, and she could see through that window while lying down and see directly into the window across the street. She tossed and turned for over an hour, unable to sleep. Finally, she turned toward the window at about 12:10, and as she looked out, she saw the boy stab his father.
That's what I mean. That's the whole case.
I think this is unshakable testimony. I don't understand how you can vote for acquittal.
Well, maybe. There's so much evidence to sift, and I think that...
What do you mean, maybe? She's absolutely right. You can throw out all the other evidence.
That was my feeling. I don't deny the validity of the point she's made. Shall we say on one side of the tracks there is doubt? But what can you say about the story of the woman? She saw it.
I'm sorry. What time is it?
6:10.
You don't suppose they'd let us go home and finish it in the morning? The little girl's got the flu.
Not a chance.
Can't you see the clock without your glasses?
Not clearly.
Oh.
Glasses are a nuisance, aren't they?
Well, what do you all do when you wake up at night and want to know what time it is?
I put on my glasses and then I look at the clock.
I just lie in bed and wait for the clock to chime.
Do you wear your glasses to bed?
Of course not. No one wears glasses to bed.
The woman who testified that she saw the killing wears glasses. What about her?
Did she wear glasses?
Of course. The woman wore bifocals. I remember this very clearly. They looked quite strong.
That's right. Bifocals. She never took them off.
Funny, I hadn't thought of that.
I think it's fair to say the woman wasn't wearing glasses in bed, and I don't think she'd put them on to glance casually out the window. The woman testified that she saw the killing the instant she looked out and that the lights went out a split second later. She couldn't have had time to put on her glasses then. Now, supposing the woman honestly thought she saw the boy kill his father, I'd say she only saw a blur.
How do you know what she saw? Maybe she's farsighted. How does she know all these things?
Does anyone else still think that there's not a reasonable doubt?
I will always wonder. But There is a reasonable doubt.
Anyone else?
I think he's guilty.
Does anyone else?
No. I'm convinced there is a reasonable doubt.
You're alone. It's 11 votes, not guilty. 1, guilty.
I don't care whether I'm alone or not. I have a right.
Yes, you have a right.
Well, I told you. I think the kid's guilty.
Well, we need your arguments.
I gave you my arguments.
We're not convinced. We're waiting to hear them again. We have time.
Listen, what's the matter with you? You're the lady. You made all the arguments. You can't turn now. This kid is a murderer.
I'm sorry. I'm convinced, okay? I don't think I'm wrong very often, but I guess I was this once. There is a reasonable doubt.
We're waiting.
You're not gonna intimidate me! I have a right! It's gonna be a hung jury. That's it.
Well, there's nothing we can do about that except hope that some night while you may be able to get some sleep.
You're all alone. It takes a great deal of courage to stand alone.
If it is a hung jury, there will be another trial and some of us will bring these points up to various lawyers.
All right!
Not guilty.
Not guilty.